there recently about the Constitution and constitutional rights, particularly in the context of the COVID-19 restrictions, and particularly in the context of the Gemma O'Doherty and John Waters challenge to the state's introduction of regulations and laws dealing with the COVID-19 pandemic. And I've made a few videos and published them on YouTube about the case, the High Court case in the first instance, and then the Court of Appeal by the pair O'Doherty and Waters after that. I've made a number of videos. And a lot of the commentary that I get is from people saying words along the lines of, is the Constitution of no benefit? All our rights are being taken away from us. We don't have any rights. What about the Constitution? And one of the pieces of videotape or TV footage that I saw when O'Doherty and Waters were going to High Court was Gemma O'Doherty walking along the quays outside the four courts in Dublin, waving the Constitution. This is the Constitution, Bunreacht na hÉireann. And it was as if this was the trump card. This was going to win the case. This was going to come to her defence and allow the court to find that she and John Waters knew better than the government, knew better than the state, and the laws introduced and the regulations to regulate people's travel, movements and so forth in the public interest were unconstitutional. That was the argument. And as I say, the Bunreacht na hÉireann was being waved around on the forecourts and in the quays, along the quays for the cameras and so forth. But people don't, or a lot of people don't realise, I suppose, that the personal rights arising from the Constitution are all qualified. None of them are unqualified rights. And if I could just draw your attention to a particular section of those, or that Constitution, I'll do so now. In this book here, Constitutional Law in Ireland by James Casey, in the chapter dealing with personal rights and the Constitution, it says, in Murray versus Ireland 1991 case, Justice McCarthy said, quote, it is difficult to identify a constitutional right that is unqualified. The right to life itself is not absolute. And then it goes on to deal with the personal rights and the rights enumerated in Article 40. Now, all of the rights in Article 40 are either expressly or implicitly subject to qualification. Freedom of expression, freedom of assembly, and freedom of association are all subject to public order and morality. That's Article 40.6, subsection 1. The rights to personal liberty and to inviolability of the dwelling are both subject to regulation in accordance with law. This is a phrase which, while not giving the legislature carte blanche to do what they like, clearly gives them a fair degree of leeway. The unenumerated rights, as is evident from their textual base in Article 40.3, are guaranteed as far as is practicable, and the state's obligation is to protect them, quote, as best it may from unjust attack. So it's clear that the rights in the Constitution are not unqualified. The right of a child, for example, to a primary school education comes into conflict with the right of a teacher to withdraw labour and go on strike. The right to your good name and my good name comes into conflict with somebody else's right to freedom of speech. So there's a constant coming into conflict of various rights, your rights and my rights, and none of them are absolute or unqualified. And they're all qualified to a certain extent. Now, if I just turn to the personal rights in the Constitution itself and deal with a couple of them, you'll see exactly what I mean. So this is the Constitution of Ireland, Bunreacht na hÉireann. And in it, there is Article 40 under the heading of Fundamental Rights and Personal Rights. Article 41 says, all citizens shall, as human persons, be held equal before the law. This shall not be held to mean that the state shall not, in its enactments, have due regard to differences of capacity, physical and moral, and of social function. 40.3 says, subsection 1, the state guarantees in its laws to respect and, as far as practicable by its laws, to defend and vindicate the personal rights of the citizen. Again, that's a right that's qualified. 40.3 subsection 2 says the state shall, in particular, by its laws, protect as best it may from unjust attack, and so on, vindicate the life, person, good name and property rights of every citizen, as best it may. Article 40.3 says the state acknowledges the right to life of the unborn, and with due regard to the equal right to life of the mother, guarantees in its laws to respect, and as far as practicable by its laws, to defend and vindicate that right. There's that phrase again, as far as is practicable. In other words, the rights are not unqualified, and the right to life of the unborn must take into account clearly the right to life of the mother. Article 40.4 says, no, 0.1 says, no citizen shall be deprived of his personal liberty save in accordance with the law. Again, you won't be deprived of your personal liberty except as set out in the law. Article 40.5 says, the dwelling of every citizen is inviolable and shall not be forcibly entered save in accordance with law. 40.6.1 says the state guarantees liberty for the exercise of the following rights subject to public order and morality. The right of the citizens to express freely their convictions and opinions. The right of the citizen to assemble peaceably and without arms. The right of citizens to form associations and unions. But it says laws, however, may be enacted for the regulation and control in the public interest of the exercise of the foregoing right. Article 43 then deals with private property. It says the state acknowledges that man, in virtue of its rational being, has the natural right antecedent to positive law to the private ownership of external goods. 40.1.2 says the state accordingly guarantees to pass no law attempting to abolish the right of private ownership or the general right to transfer, bequeath and inherit property. However, 43.2 says that the state recognises, however, that the exercise of the rights mentioned in the foregoing provisions of this article ought, in civil society, to be regulated by the principles of social justice. Again, that's another right that is qualified, that's modified by some other part of the Constitution. And 40.2.2 says the state accordingly may, as occasion requires, delimit by law the exercise of the said rights with a view to reconciling their exercise with the exigencies of the common good. So the state has the right, subject to the common good, to delimit by law the exercise of the said rights to private property. 44 deals with religion. 45 deals with directive principles of social policy. But I hope you can see from this Bunreacht na hÉireann Constitution of Ireland that we all have rights. However, those rights are not unqualified. They are modified. They are modified to a huge degree, and there is a good degree of discretion given to the state to modify rights and to bring in laws in the public interest and for the public good and so on and so forth. And the bottom line is, no rights are unqualified, and the idea that the Constitution doesn't stand for something is not the case. The Constitution stands for plenty of things, but it stands for your rights and my rights, and it recognises the social good, it recognises the public interest, and it does make provision for the qualification or modification or delimiting of rights in certain circumstances. And in the current climate with the COVID-19 pandemic going on, the state obviously has introduced laws which they believe are in the public interest and will curtail people's right to travel, right to associate, right to gather, and so on. But that's the challenge that was facing O'Doherty and Waters with their judicial review. It didn't succeed. There's another case coming down the line. I see, I think I saw a video the other day there, Tracey O'Mahony, her group, who have put together some sort of funding with a Fund Me campaign, are challenging by way of a plenary process rather than judicial review, and they may well succeed, who knows. I think they are going at it more from the point of view of the unconstitutionality of the regulations, which were brought into law. In other words, that the regulations which were brought into law by the various departments or by ministers exceeded the powers that they should have been given, and exceeded the principle of the policies and procedures delimiting factor that they have to work within. In other words, it is the Oireachtas that enacts legislation in this country. Anyway, that's another argument down the line. I'm sure it'll be well canvassed and well aired in the relevant court, but I just thought I'd make this video to clarify for people who are leaving comments on some of my videos on YouTube, asking the question essentially, does the Constitution not stand for anything? It does, but it doesn't stand for unqualified rights. Rights are qualified, no rights are absolute. Even the right to life is not absolute, it's qualified by other things, and that has been held to be the case by the Supreme Court and various courts down through the since the foundation of the state. Hope you find this video useful. If you do, I'd appreciate if you gave it the thumbs up down below. Thanks a lot.